Hello everyone, welcome back to the Motivation Medicose. My name is Prince Tiwari and today we are going to study about the portal vein. So it's very easy to learn the portal vein. For that you just have to watch this video till the end. One more thing guys, if you are new at our channel, so please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon, because here we replace long boring lecture and the books into a short and easy. All you need is a paper, pen and a short amount of time, that's it. So let's come to the our topic, it's a portal vein. So about the portal vein, or we can say the portal system, it includes all the veins draining the abdominal part of the digestive tube, but there is exceptions which are the lower part of the rectum and the anal canal, and also it is also receive the veins from the spleen, pancreas and the gallbladder. So let's talk about the formation. So it is formed by the union of superior mesenteric and the splenic vein and the level of L2 vertebra behind the neck of the pancreas and in the front of the inferior vena cava. So, and one more thing, it begins like a vein from the capillary plexus of gut and ends like a artery, by dividing the hepatic sinus. We just have seen, the veins have the tributaries, but it also has a branch as well. So it was about the formation. So with the help of diagram, we'll understand the portal vein. So I'm just making the diagram over here. So in the very first, we'll make the liver over here. It's a liver. I'm just making the duodenum over here. I'm making the pancreas. So here, we have a pancreas. One more diagram we have. Here, I'm making this spleen. That's spleen. So let's talk about the portal vein. So the portal vein, it begins from the behind of the neck of the pancreas, means it's a neck of the pancreas, and it begins from here by the confluence of two major veins, that is splenic vein, coming from the hilum. It's a spleen. So one vein comes from over here, the hilum, the hilum of the splenic vein. So I'm just making it's coming from over here, it's a superior mesenteric vein. Superior mesenteric vein. Let me give the name. It's what? It is a splenic vein, and it's superior mesenteric vein. So both will, these both will join over here. It's a behind the neck of pancreas. It's join over here behind the neck of pancreas, and it will make what? The portal vein. Or we can say it's a site of formation of portal vein here. It's a behind of neck of the pancreas. So it is also said to be a site of the formation of portal vein. It is also, it's very important, often asked as in a various MCQ exams. And it passes, from the behind, it's a first part of the, duodenum. So it passes from the first part of the duodenum. And then it goes upward, and it goes upward till it reaches, till it reaches the porta hepatis, where it divides into, two branch. We'll consider this, into the branch after, and then it enters into the liver. It's a liver. Now let's talk about the coats. So the coats of whole portal vein, okay, it's a portal vein, so can be divided into three parts. Okay, I'm just writing the names over here. The first part, I'm talking about the coats. So first part, it's a infra, okay, duodenal part. I'm just writing the shortcut over here. It's infra duodenal part. And the second part, it's a retro duodenal part. And the third one, it's a supra duodenal part. So let's talk about the infraduodenal part. So the infraduodenal part, this is the part lies below the first part of the duodenum. It means it's the first part of, you know, duodenum. It lies below, means this part, okay, this part, okay, it is said to be infraduodenum part. Let's talk about the retroduodenal part. So the posterior side, okay, the posterior side of the first part of duodenum, okay, the retroduodenal part lies. And above, okay, above first part of duodenal, okay, it's a what? It's a first part of duodenum. So the above this, okay, here you can see this is space. This is what? It's a supra duodenal part. Let's talk about the relations. Okay, so to understand the relation, I'm making over here relations. I'm writing over here relations. What was that? Okay, it's a spleen. Don't get confused. Spleen. Okay, so to understand the relation, okay, we'll consider the anterior relation and the posterior relation. So it's one thing, it's very common, okay, for all these three, the infraduodenal and this, it's a posterior relation, okay, that would be common in all threes. That, okay, the posterior relation, it would be, okay, the common, it's what? It's a inferior vena cava. So let's talk about the relation. So in inferior, you know, infraduodenal, okay, what, okay, it's infraduodenal part, we'll see the anterior relations are over here. It's what? It's a neck of pancreas. And posteriorly, you know, it's what? It's a inferior vena cava. It's common for all these. Now let's talk about the retroduodenal. So in the retroduodenal, it's what? Retroduodenal present behind or the posterior part of the first part of the duodenum. So the anterior relation, it would be the first, okay, part of duodenal along with the gastroduodenal artery and the common bile duct, okay. And the posterior, okay, it is also again same. It's what? It's a inferior vena cava. And let's talk about the last one, okay, it's what? It's a superior part. So the superior part, okay, they are anteriorly, okay, lies hepatic artery and the common bile duct, means the duct, okay, it's lying to the right, okay, and while the hepatic artery, it lies to the left, okay. It was all about what? The relations. Now let's come to the branch, okay. So branch, here you can see, okay, the branch before entering the liver, okay. Let me make, so here you can see the before entering the liver through the porta hepatitis, the portal vein divides into two part. Okay, here you can see the left part, okay, and the right part. It's a right part, okay, it's a right part, and it's what? It's a left part, okay. And this right part, okay, it's a shorter and wider. It enters, okay, into the right lobe, okay, right lobe of the liver by after receiving the cystic vein. And this left, okay, it's a longer and narrower, and it enters into the left, okay, lobe of the liver. Now let's come to the tributary, okay. So to understand the tributary, okay, I'm just writing the tributary over here. So now we're talking about tributaries. So it's very easy to understand the tributaries, okay, with the help of mnemonics. I just have made the mnemonics. It is what? It's a savior, saves a smile, and love courageous people. It means you guys also will be a savior, okay, very soon. And okay, you guys, okay, save the smile of the patient and love also the courageous people. So from this, okay, I just made one mnemonic. It is savior saves smile and love courageous people. From this mnemonics, okay, you can easily learn what the tributaries. So from the from Savior we'll consider ass. So from the ass, we have a splenic vein, and from this ass, we have a superior mesenteric vein, where you have superior mesenteric vein. And from the another ass, we also have it's a superior pancreatico caudinal vein. Superior pancreatic vein. And from the L, we have a left and right gastric vein. And we'll consider C from the courageous. So from the C we have a cystic vein. And in the last, we'll consider P. So from the P we have a para umbilical vein. I'm writing shortcut over here, I'll mention para umbilical vein. So it was all about the tributaries. So let's draw the tributaries. So to understand the tributaries, and these, these two veins, you can see the splenic vein and the superior mesenteric vein, these will act like a formative tributaries, because they are forming the a portal vein. So they are forming the portal vein, these both. So these acts like a formative tributaries. So let's come to the now we'll talk one by one. We'll cover the tributaries over here. So here, we have an inferior mesenteric vein. It's a inferior mesenteric vein. That drain into the splenic vein. This vein, it drains into the splenic vein. Now, we have two vein, in the trunk, that arise, one vein, over here. That will supply to the, stomach, these both. So one is, over here. It's a left gastric vein and it's right gastric vein. And one branch drain into the right part of this portal vein. And the left as well. So one vein is drain into over here, and one vein into the right. So the branch draining into the left branch, it means over here, it is said to be a para umbilical vein. And one more vein drain into the right branch of the portal vein, it is said to be a cystic vein. And one more thing, from the, so we just have, covered all the veins, the splenic vein, you can see splenic vein, this is the splenic vein, and it is also, we just have covered all the vein, from the left gastric branch, where is the left gastric branch, here, branch, few, oesophageal branches draining the lower part of the oesophagus, and these, these both, the right and the left, they will, drain into the stomach. So it was all about the tributary and the portal vein. Thanks for watching our video, guys.